Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? This week is International Dark Sky Week, and a number of organizations are stepping up their education efforts. So in order to see the galaxies I'll be discussing in a moment, you'll need less light spilling up into the sky. Here's some ideas on how you can get involved. Share on social media. IDA, Globe at Night, Astronomers Without Borders, and Eyes on the Sky share blog posts, graphics, and videos with your friends so they can become aware of this problem. Change or reorient lights on your own home to make a difference, and after you do, talk to your neighbors about the benefits. Alternatively, take measurements for Globe at Night, become a dark sky ranger, throw a local star party, or photograph the night sky, either light polluted or not, for World at Night. All of these help raise awareness, but the best ones are where you actively talk to others and do your part by speaking up. Always be respectful of others' thoughts and opinions, and remember that you making changes first can have a great impact by both increasing demand for dark sky lighting, but also by demonstrating to your neighbors that dark sky friendly lighting doesn't mean a dark ground. And when the sky is darker, we all benefit, like being able to see galaxies. So back to that. In the southeastern section of the sky, about 3 hours after sunset, the planet Saturn and the stars Spica and Regulus are close to the line of the ecliptic. Moving back from Regulus and slightly to the north of that line, we can find Arcturus a good 60 degrees away. But look almost halfway in between. Leo's tail star, Denebola, is a 2.1 magnitude A-class star. We can find three galaxies near here called Leo's triplet. Starting at Denebola, move your finder scope back towards Regulus, just a bit more than one full field of view. From darker areas, this star is easily visible, 3.3 magnitude Chirton. Another star seen in darker skies is 4th magnitude Iota Leonis, just 5.5 degrees from Chirton. Between these very white-appearing stars is a somewhat orange-appearing K-class star that can be spotted naked eye from truly dark locations, 5.3 magnitude, 73 Leonis. In your finder scope are two other stars that form a near-perfect right triangle with this star, but they are slightly dimmer at magnitude 7. The key to finding the galaxies is to place the 7th magnitude star that forms the right angle corner of this triangle at the center of your finder scope field. A mere quarter of a degree away to the south of this star is M65, a spiral galaxy at not quite an edge-on appearance to us. Just a half a degree away to the southeast is M66, which is a bit more open-faced. To really enhance your odds of seeing these, use a telescope of 114 millimeters or larger. But the real challenge, even under better conditions, is to spot the third galactic companion, NGC 3628. At a slightly larger size and slightly dimmer magnitude, its combined light will be more difficult to detect. Look north and east of the 7th magnitude right angle apex star. Under ideal conditions, all three galaxies can be seen in the same 1 degree field of view. If you're unable to see them, work to reduce light pollution in your area. It's going to take a lot of us working together to make a change. Take just one step this week and start making a difference. The moon is new on the 10th, but swings by Jupiter on the 14th as a slim crescent. Saturn is now visible in the sky with Jupiter as it rises just a few hours after sunset. Look in the east for the ringed planet. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.